think we should stop saying a couple of things when it comes to sex and violence in the media. People tend to think, well, and they say, if you watch violent material, you'll become a violent person. It's exactly the same as saying, if you watch Westerns, you'll become a cowboy. And we'd never say that, because we don't. Maybe we do in far north Queensland, I don't know. But it is reality, though, that these questions are coming earlier and earlier and earlier into kids' lives. Kids are getting exposed to much gross levels of violence, and even mainstream stuff like Game of Thrones is an unbelievably violent show. And my problem with that is that it desensitizes kids and it makes them have a lack of empathy, a sense of empathy about real life violence. Like, real violence is true and that's what's happening in the world. Cartoonish media violence tends to trivialize real life violence, and kids lack an empathy, and they can also have a sense of being desensitized. When it comes to sex, the problem is that those questions are coming, being introduced so much earlier into kids' lives. We now know from 4 reputable studies in Australia that the earliest that a child is being introduced to pornography, is the average age is 10, and they're often by older siblings. So it's 15, 16, 17-year-old brothers and sisters who think it's funny to introduce their 10-year-old brother or sister to pornography online. Now, how does a 10-year-old deal with some of the stuff sexually? How does any of us deal with what's online sexually? And my issue here is that for us, sex is a gift given to us to help us thrive as a human being, and we have to claim the dignity that comes with it. With every gift comes a responsibility. Well, sex is a gift. We want to be very positive about it. We want to talk about the responsibility of exercising that gift with dignity and bestowing it on other people. In all of this stuff, the best thing is to be open and keep talking to your kids. Don't shut down, don't get moralistic, and don't fight, because kids stop talking. Trying to have calm conversations about what we're worried about, what the anxieties are behind these issues, that can only lead to having a fruitful relationship where we can get the best possible outcome for our kids as they grow up.